How to use eBay Markdown sales to grow your eBay sales, gain and maintain velocity of sales. Hello again, ladies and gents. Welcome back to the channel. If you're new here, I'm Polish Pete and I sell ladies' clothing on eBay. I buy them in job lots and bundles wherever I can, as cheap as I can, and then sell them individually on eBay, making about £5 profit per item. Today we are going to talk about markdown sales. This is an episode number 7 of the series How to Grow Your eBay Sales. If you haven't watched previous episodes, I should suggest you to do it. The link to the playlist is over here, and the links to all the episodes are in the description box below. So let's start. When you sell on saturated market and you go by the volume like me, you have to list a lot of items, and some of those items will be better than the others, more attractive, more interesting. You know, and they will sell faster, but some of the items will stay listed for a longer period of time, maybe for a year, maybe for two, maybe three, whatever. So we have to apply some sort of the way to get rid of them. Yes, you could lower the price, you know, in the race to the bottom really, but I don't think it's a good idea. That will just eat your profit, and even lowering the price will not kind of give you the certainty that the item will sell. And yes, I do lower the prices on my items, but I do it every 6 months. So I try to sell that item for the price that I want for them, for it, you know, for 6 months. And if it doesn't sell, I lower the price a bit. And then I do it again after next 6 months, and next 6 months, and next six months, you know. But for those 6 months, I'm trying, you know, my best to push the item out. I'm just, you know, trying to give it a chance to sell. Lowering the price is easy, and, you know, it's just a couple of clicks and it's done. But, you know, doing that too often will just eat your profit very quick. So one of the things that I do is a markdown sale. And yes, it's lowering the price of the item, but it's lowering the price a bit different way. Now, there is no point for me to show you how to set up the markdown sales. There is probably thousands of videos on YouTube how to do it. I would rather tell you about some principles that I stick to, you know, a greater plan that I have, a bigger picture, you know, that I use to run those markdown sales. Something more than just getting rid of sticky stock. We have to remember that our goal is not to sell more items for the discounted price. Our goal is to convince the algorithm that your account and your items are worth to send the traffic to. So it has to be that markdown sales have to be a part of that magic wheel of velocity. Yeah. Besides of being a tool to get rid of sticky stock, it has to also be a tool to gain and maintain that velocity. So first of all, in my opinion, and obviously I don't have to be right, it's much better to run a 20% markdown sale than just blindly lower the price by 20%. People love bargains, yeah? If it wasn't the case, supermarkets wouldn't be full of markdown offers. People love those striked prices. I used to work in a supermarket, and I've seen people buying like crazy an item that was marked down by 2 pence, only because it was just a yellow label. It is also worth to mention that in the UK there are specific laws regulating the markdown offers, and eBay has to adhere to them. So item has to be marked for the full price for 14 days before it can go into sale. And that sale can go only for 14 days, and you have to then again wait another 14 days with a full price to put it back on the sale. So to be in line with those laws, I run markdown sales in a third week of the month. It's usually my worst week of the month anyway, so by running that sale, I can, increase my sales, bump up those listings, a bit, and get that a bit more traffic. So usually I start my sale after the second weekend of the month, and I run it throughout third week, third weekend, and the fourth week. As you can see, I don't run it during the fourth weekend, as this tends to be a good time for me on eBay. So there is no point really to discount those items when they are selling anyway. Then, after the sale is over, I've got that first and second week of the month, for my items to rest for 14 days, and I can start over again. So what kind of items do I put into the sale? So in the single sale you can put 500 items. So in my SKU field I've got a quarter and a year of when the item has been listed for the first time, and I use that to determine the oldest items, and I put into the sale those oldest items. If I have a bit of space in that 500 listings, I put my younger listings that are going out of season. So for example, in the spring, right now, I would put boots, jumpers, coats, and stuff like that into that sale, because I would rather sell them a bit cheaper than wait to next till the next year to sell them for the full price. And nobody can guarantee me that I will sell them for the full price next year. So I have to say a word about those fake sales. It's like when you inflate the price of the item and then put it down on a sale for the price you really wanted for it. I don't do it because I hate when people do it. When customer finds out that he or she bought an item on a discounted price that was actually a market price, they are not happy, not happy at all. And also, it's a mess. It's a mess. You have to, stay on top of those prices. You have to know which one are inflated, which one are not inflated, which one are discounted, which one are not discounted. To me, it's too much time and effort, too much of rubbish in my head. So, also, the other thing is, you have to keep those items on that high inflated price for 14 days to be able to put them on the markdown. So, for me, that's a waste of 14 days, really, because if the price is inflated, nobody will buy it, or not many people will buy it. At least in my case, in case of what I sell. Also, the algorithm during those 14 days when you've got those inflated prices on sees that you are not selling so much, you are not selling that much, so algorithm can stop to send you the traffic. And then you have to start all over again because you've lost that velocity. So in my opinion, it's more harm than gain, really. I would rather sell the item a bit cheaper, but sell it and move on to the next one than, wait all those 14 days, risk that algorithm to stop send me the traffic just to sell it for a couple of quid more. But that's my opinion, and you can do whatever you want. I can't stop you. Just, I would like to just ask you to start with a part of your inventory, not all. Just do it on a few items, on 100 items or whatever, and see the effects. Assess the effects and make a decision if it's worth it or not, before jumping on a full scale. And one more thing, guys. Now, I don't have a solid evidence for that. It's only my observation, only my gut feeling. But when you put some of your items on a markdown sale, it also helps the rest of the items to get more traffic. Now, I don't know why it happens, but it seems like the algorithm sends more traffic to the rest of the items as well. I've been thinking about it for a long time, probably like 2, 3 years, but I don't know how to prove it. I don't know how to measure it. I think it is because you've got all those items on a markdown sale and you get some sales out of that, and then I think algorithm sees that and sends you more traffic, not only to those markdown items, but also to those items that are not markdown. But again, I had situations where I had a markdown offer for 14 days, and I haven't sold a single item out of those markdown items, but yet I had bigger sales in that non-markdown items. So I don't really know, but I can say that I can see the increase in traffic and in sales in those all my items, not only the markdown items. Another thing that I would like to talk about is the level of the discount. You have to find your sweet spot, really. In my case, on a saturated market, cheap items, etc., I find that lowering the price by less than 15% doesn't work at all to me. Then lowering the price by 15, 20, 25, or 30% gives me the same effect. So there is no point to mark it down more than 15%. Also, I can see the increase of the sales only when I put the price down by 50%. But that increase is just tiny and doesn't cover that extra cost of lowering those prices down. So I always mark down my items by 15%. And never do it, never mark down them less or more than that. And the last thing that comes to my mind that I would like to share with you is that you have to remember that during the markdown sale, you've got those watchers. And if you want to send an offer to those watchers, you have to remember that effectively you are discounting your items twice because it already has a markdown offer on it, and you mark it down again by sending offer to a watcher. So you may end up selling that item for, way much lower price that you really wanted to sell it for. So say you do 15% markdown, and then on top of that you send 15% offer to a watcher, and you end up with almost 30%. You sell that item almost 30% cheaper that you wanted to, really. So that's a thing to remember. Right, that's it, guys, I believe, for today. I don't think I've got any more things about markdown offers for you. I don't think so. I want you to remember one thing. If you want to mark down your offer, your items, Just don't do it just to get rid of the sticky stock. Yes, get rid of the sticky stock, but keep in mind that velocity. Gain that extra velocity, gain that extra traffic to all your listings, and just don't mark down your listings when your items are selling like hotcakes. Just find the spot in the month that you are constantly having lower sales and use that markdown sales in that spot to pull it up a bit. Right, if you find this kind of content helpful and in some sick way entertaining, please give me the thumb up. Yeah, and consider subscribing to the channel if you haven't done so yet. I wish you all the best. I wish you many, many eBay sales. I wish you a great week. And God bless you all, guys. And bye-bye.